Okay, then let's talk about network evolution expansion from the XAX perspective. My name is Björn, I'm with Siemens and leading the work package 7 in XAX, and I'm also presenting on behalf of my colleague Morten, who is leading work package 5. Let's first talk a bit about evolution and expansion. For this, we have one simple example shown here in this plot. You can see on the x-axis the different generations of mobile networks. And then with the solid line, you can see an indication of the downlink peak bitrate for these different generations of networks. And you can see this has steadily increased until the latest versions. So in this case, 5G release 15, which constitutes an evolution of capabilities in a sense. At the same time, while the early version focused on voice services, later versions then included, for example, data packet handling and then more specialized services, for example, vehicular to X communication services or ultra reliable low latency communication that target specific use cases and scenarios. So you can see that there was an expansion of the communication system from purely voice-based services towards very basically special purpose functionality. Now, you have heard about the different use cases we're targeting in XAX in an earlier presentation, but from the perspective of work packages 5 and 7, we target basically three core challenges. First one being the challenge network of networks, so to be able to integrate different types of networks into an overall 6G system. The second one being extreme experiences, for example, regarding dependability, latency, throughput, and so on. This could be telepresence use cases, for example. And last but not least, global service coverage, also targeting sustainability use cases, for example, Earth Monitor or autonomous supply chains. The potential of those new use cases is that they enable new value chains. So they enable different players in the market to come up with new products and new services. But at the same time, when we want to enable such new value chains, we need to make sure that the cost of ownership is reduced accordingly. To achieve this, we have our approaches to increase flexibility and dependability and to utilize intelligence wherever possible. This is a theme that is also recurring around XAX. Now let's look at how we can increase flexibility, the dependability and the intelligence within the network. First of all, from an architecture point of view, we aim for a fully service-based cloud-native RAN and core network, because this is one way that we can achieve integrated and distributed AI and programmability throughout the whole network. It is also an enabler and potential help in integrating a wide range of devices and subnetworks that are already out there and that target specific, very demanding requirements, especially in the vertical domain. Enabling these kind of special purpose network solutions to exist within the 6G ecosystem and thereby expand towards these new value chains is an important mission of work packages 5 and 7. And last but not least, to enable humans to directly interact with the system and to work towards the fusion of these three different worlds, we look into new human-machine interaction enablers and into fully immersive digital twins, especially within the context of Work Package 7. In order to contribute towards this network evolution and expansion, we identified four work areas that I would briefly present in the following slides. First of all, we're looking into specialized and flexible networks. And as you can see on the right-hand side, you have multitude of different types of networks, of access technologies and enablers that need to be integrated into the overall 6G architecture. And the goal here is to be able to enhance the performance of the network by integrating those technologies in a cost-efficient fashion. At the same time, one goal is to achieve global service coverage. So these access technologies need to be able to provide services to remote areas as well. And last but not least, as I just discussed, we need to take care of different networks that live within the 6G network, for example, a subnetwork within a car or within an auto, within a factory. Some enablers that we're looking at in XAX are the efficient integration of nodes in other frequency areas, for example, above the 100 GHz spectrum, visible light communication, mesh networks, and so on. Also considering cell-free networks and local device networks, as I just mentioned. We're also looking into enhancement of the radio access virtualization methods, into local ad hoc networks management, and into zero energy devices, especially regarding sustainable coverage of large areas and with respect to the realization of use cases like the Earth Monitor. The second area are service-based networks. Here, the idea is that services should be independent from each other. They should be reusable and flexible. And in one way to achieve this is to reduce the signal needs. So this is one of the goals here. Also, another goal is to avoid unnecessary duplication of functionalities and thereby also reduce the complexity of the overall system, which in turn aims to reduce the total cost of ownership. In the end, when you have this basically swarm of functionalities or independent services, you can use AI to achieve a truly intelligent network in terms of management and operation. How do we want to do that? First of all, as I already mentioned, we want to enable fully cloud-native RAN and core network functions. We want to streamline the design and the redesign of signaling procedures and interfaces for those cloud-native RANs and core networks. And last but not least, we are researching into new protocols and components for distributed and centralized AI, also together with other work packages in HexaX. The third goal is dynamic and efficient dependability. Here, the idea is that the 6G network serves basically as the connectivity or service platform across different verticals. And in order to realize the use cases that these verticals are aiming for, you need to achieve better dependability and reliability. This also translates to an increase in connectivity and coverage in such challenging environments, most likely always with very challenging performance requirements. One way we tackle that within HexaX is to develop such special purpose network solutions for specific application areas and how look at how they can be integrated into the overall 6G ecosystem. We're looking into flexible heterogeneous resource planning, especially considering mobile devices such as HV or robots. We're looking into methods for resource sharing. So if, for example, frequency is to be shared across different access technologies. And we're also looking into multiplexing transmissions across 3GPP and non-3GPP access technologies. So to best utilize basically what's there and what's available within the respective use case. Now, the fourth and last area we're looking into are human machine interfaces and digital twins. Here we're looking, for example, into novel HMI concepts that allow multi-user and multi-CPE interaction, but also into execution environments for privacy preserving and dependent digital twin. Those execution environments can then benefit from the flexible resource planning and utilization that we also mentioned in the earlier contributions in order to really adapt to the specific environment and the specific scenario, for example, in a vertical setting. Again, this already concludes my brief overview. The first deliverables for work packages 5 and 7 are expected soon, so if you're interested, please have a look at our website, hexax.eu. And there you can also find the other deliverables that have already been produced. And in case of questions, please feel free to ask them now right after the presentation. Thank you.